Flight 9 continued delays are an unfortunate reality check, especially for those of us anticipating its departure in the second half of this month. That said, SpaceX has many important goals to meet before its upcoming launch. What remains to be accomplished? Furthermore, is there a chance that the launch will happen this month? Let's discuss more in today's episode of NR Studio. Of course, the anticipation surrounding Flight 9 is palpable, not only because of its status as another Starship launch, but also because it signals SpaceX's determination to revive the mission to ensure success after two flights filled with difficulties and setbacks. Many launch predictions have been floating around, with some suggesting April 18th, while I optimistically predicted April 20th. However, it is becoming increasingly clear that these dates may not be reliable. SpaceX has a significant amount of preparatory work remaining before the start of its next flight window. Let's start with the hardware. The B-14 recently completed its static fire test, marking a major milestone in its development. The craft is currently undergoing post-test evaluation at Mega Bay 1. Post-fire inspections are critical to the engine systems. While the static fire results appear favorable, there are suggestions that the B-14 may have experienced complications during the assessment. SpaceX must ensure that the engines are not damaged by the rigorous firing sequence. A major emphasis will be placed on the igniter system. Engine ignition issues have been shown to affect the B-14 and B-15 during previous flights. Thus, ensuring flawless performance in this regard is critical. According to the challenge, a significant number of the B-14 Raptor engines are comprised of reused components, having previously been used on previous missions. This underscores the importance of conducting comprehensive inspections. Additional systems, including the fuel tanks and louver fins, require regular assessments to ensure they are operationally ready for the mission. In addition to these assessments, SpaceX is required to implement two additional critical systems, the hot staging and the flight termination system. The hot staging in particular has attracted significant attention. Although officially recognized as a component of the upgrade package for this flight, there is speculation that complications with this system may have played a role in the separation issues observed on previous missions. The previous stacking clamp mechanism had caused a last-minute abort, highlighting another issue that SpaceX must resolve before moving forward. The system is critical to stage separation and control mid-flight. Therefore, it was critical to iron out any potential deficiencies. Meanwhile, in Mega Bay 2, the S-35, designated to pair with the B-14 for Flight 9, did make progress, albeit at a slightly slower pace than previously anticipated. On April 13th, SpaceX successfully delivered and presumably completed the installation of its Raptor engines. The next milestone involves the execution of a static firing test. However, there has been a significant delay in the schedule. The S-35 recently returned from the Massey test site after undergoing cryogenic testing on February 13th, indicating that it would take approximately a month to advance to the engine installation stage. All indications are that SpaceX needs a significant amount of additional time before the integration of the two stages. While a late April launch seems increasingly unlikely, the progress we have seen shows a clear commitment and determination to achieve excellence. After this latest advancement, the S-35 still has a significant to-do list to complete before it is deemed ready for launch. The next major milestone is the static firing test. Given the engine anomalies and systemic issues identified during the previous two flights, it is anticipated that this test will be conducted in several distinct phases. Each phase could feature variations in duration, thrust intensity, and fuel load to effectively replicate a variety of flight conditions and stressors. These variations are important not only to validate baseline performance, but also to uncover any underlying issues as the vehicle approaches its operational limits in a controlled environment. Once the static fire test is complete, the S-35 will be transported back to Mega Bay 2 for further diagnostic analysis and evaluation. The engine compartment will be given top priority, especially considering that it has emerged as the most frequent failure point in recent missions. Electronics will perform a thorough inspection of each Raptor engine to ensure there are no remaining issues, including excessive harmonic response, fuel leaks, pressure buildup, or indications of heat-induced damage. Potential solutions could include strengthening the nitrogen venting and purging systems, improving fire suppression mechanisms, and implementing additional structural protection as needed. Additionally, the fuel tank systems located further along the vehicle will be subject to a thorough inspection. The liquid oxygen tanks on the S-35 showed signs of instability prior to launch. Therefore, it is critical that the tanks on the S-35 undergo a thorough inspection, regardless of whether the progenic validation has been successfully completed. The quiet period the S-35 spent on Mega B the 2nd of May require a comprehensive internal assessment and upgrade of these subsystems. Nevertheless, continuous real-time monitoring of these tanks will be required throughout the final integration and launch process. During these assessments, the S-35 will be equipped with critical onboard systems, such as the flight termination system and payload bay installation. These elements are intrinsically linked to flight safety and mission objectives, requiring their integration with meticulous precision. Specifically, payload installation may introduce new aerodynamic or balance factors. As a result, engineers are expected to assess performance metrics before, during, and after this process. Once the S-35 and B-14 have been thoroughly prepared, they will proceed to the launch pad for the conclusive phase of pre-launch evaluation. A key action that SpaceX anticipates reintroducing is the wet dress rehearsal. This comprehensive system test accurately replicates the countdown and fuel loading procedures, stopping just before engine ignition. It was previously overlooked before the final flight. However, given the challenges faced, it may reemerge as a critical milestone to ensure system stability and prevent abort on launch day. All of this highlights that, as with the B-14, the preparation cycle for the S-35 is anything but short, and this is only in terms of the hardware aspects. Furthermore, SpaceX must deftly navigate the regulatory landscape to secure launch authorization. The FAA has now completed its investigation into the incident involving Flight 7. The investigation into Flight 8 is ongoing, and while a launch could theoretically occur before its conclusion, SpaceX must obtain formal authorization from the FAA before proceeding. This authorization typically occurs after a verified readiness status, indicating that it will not be granted until SpaceX has resolved most, if not all, of its technical challenges. It is increasingly unlikely that Flight 9 will lift off during April. This would mean that SpaceX could potentially miss out on the opportunity to conduct two Starship missions in consecutive months, a milestone it accomplished last year with Flights 5 and 6. Furthermore, the interval between flights could exceed the 9-day span observed between Flights 7 and 8. In order to reduce that interval, Flight 9 would have to begin its launches before April 2nd, a deadline that currently appears unattainable. While this may be disappointing to some, it is important to note that the long time frame underscores SpaceX dedication to excellence and safety. Rather than rushing to another test flight, the team is diligently using this time to refine, improve, and strengthen every component of the system. Ultimately, what matters most is the successful completion of the mission. Once SpaceX successfully executes this launch, the frequency of Starship flights is anticipated to increase significantly, potentially exceeding our expectations. The bottom line is that the foundation is being laid for significant progress. Let's keep our enthusiasm up and support the team working hard behind the scenes. If you support Flight 9, please show your support by commenting "Go Flight 9" in the comments below. If you have any new information regarding the launch date, please feel free to share it. We are all in this countdown together. Of course, if Flight 9 is delayed from April to May, the delay could potentially pave the way for a series of exciting developments, making May the most important month in Starship history. SpaceX momentum is poised to continue beyond Flight 9. Indeed, preparations for Flight 10 are already well underway. B-16, designated for the mission, successfully passed its cryogenic endurance test in March. It is now ready and prepared to move into static fire testing as soon as the launch pad is cleared for the Flight 9 campaign. Meanwhile, S-36 may have completed its production phase and be ready for cryogenic testing by then. If B-16 and S-36 maintain their momentum without interruption, coupled with the success of Flight 9, we may indeed witness not one, but a pair of Starship launches in May. This would be a significant milestone for SpaceX, as it would complete two full Starship launches in a single calendar month for the first time. An additional source of excitement comes from the growing anticipation surrounding Flight 10, which may mark the occasion when SpaceX attempts to capture the ship's return stage using Mechazilla, the robust launch and recovery system incorporated into the launch tower. This is a significant step toward realizing Starship's full reusability, confirming that Launch Pad B is gradually approaching operational readiness. The fire diverter, also known as the fire bucket, has recently been repositioned, expertly orchestrating the ongoing preparation of the runway for the demanding launch and landing activities. The Mechazilla launch tower and capture arm have been operational for a considerable duration and have undergone extensive testing, thereby increasing confidence that the capture of the ship will be accomplished soon. However, what makes the coming weeks more exciting goes beyond just SpaceX efforts. It signals a potential comprehensive confrontation across the industry. May could see a remarkable convergence in spaceflight as three of the industry's most formidable competitors, SpaceX, Blue Origin, and ULA, prepare to launch within weeks or even days of each other. Starting with Blue Origin, the firm is said to be scheduling a second New Glenn launch in late spring. Investigations into the incident from the initial mission have been completed, and preparations are underway to transport critical hardware, including the rocket's upcoming second stage. If all goes as anticipated, the New Glenn 2 launch is set to take place in May, with Blue Origin aiming to achieve a major milestone of its own, successfully securing a critical booster on an unmanned ship, thereby propelling their vehicle into the era of reusability. CEO Dave Limp has asserted that the company is diligently pursuing this goal, which would directly challenge SpaceX's entrenched supremacy in reusable rocket technology. At the same time, ULA maintains an active manifest and is ready to execute either of two critical national security missions, USSF 106 or 87 during the second quarter of this year. To meet that schedule, a May launch will be a must. Importantly, this mission will represent ULA's first flight since gaining certification to conduct operational launches using its Vulcan Centaur rocket. Given the challenges faced with its solid rocket motor during previous flights, the upcoming mission is critical to show off its improved reliability and performance. It will also illuminate ULA's ability to maintain its competitive edge alongside SpaceX and Blue Origin in this new era of high-cadence, frequent launches. When combined, all of these factors suggest that May is poised to be a pivotal month in the contemporary commercial space race. In a notable development, SpaceX, Blue Origin, and ULA were recently selected by the Space Force to participate in the National Security Space Launch Program, marking the first time these formidable competitors can compete not only on ambition, but also on the launch calendar. The outcome of this flight could significantly impact the future government contracting landscape, guide technological advancements, and determine industry leadership. Without a doubt, the key element of this entire timeline is Flight 9. If SpaceX can successfully achieve Flight 9, it will lay the groundwork not only for Flight 10, but also for a significant acceleration of the entire Starship program. If you are still waiting for Flight 9, rest assured that persistence is key. What lies beyond the delay may not only meet expectations, but exceed them in a big way. That's it for today's episode. See you in the next one, and thank you for your support.